Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Inject3ble. So in this video I'm going to discuss about the transformer dot convection and most important and most doubtful concept for so many of you. Okay, so after watching this video I'm sure you won't get any problem in dot convention. So there are so many questions framed on this topic in gate. Okay, so let's watch the video, okay, without miss any point. So first of all, see, I have made different type of configurations, like different possibilities of configurations by using the windings. First of all, see the first winding. So this is our core, okay, and I am giving the supply here and I am getting the I'm connected to the load in the secondary terminal. Okay, now see, carefully observe here, winding is made on the limb. Like this is the limb and this winding is made on the limb, and here see, winding is made from below the limb. Okay, so let's see some basics before going to this. So as you know, the Lenz law means effect opposes the cause. For example, because of this source voltage, okay, some current is flowing in this, so this current in this winding produces some EMF. Okay, so because of input voltage, EMF current will flow. Okay, so this current produces flux, so because of this flux there is some EMF. So in the first winding, like in the first winding, what is the effect? What is the effect? Effect is the EMF, production of EMF. What is the cause? So flux, EMF is produced because of flux, and flux is produced because of current flowing, and current is produced because of voltage. So this is the cause, the main cause. So this is the cause and this is the effect. So now according to Lenz law, effect opposes the cause. That means this EMF, like in the direction which tends to decreases the this voltage. So that's why we are writing, suppose this is the positive and negative, this is Vn. So that's why we are writing, so this is the winding, EMF as a plus and negative, like this EMF. So that's, if you see, this EMF is subtracting this. If you find out the resultant EMF or resultant voltage across this terminal, okay, so you will get the like Vin minus Vout. Okay, so that means these two subtraction, this means this EMF is not adding with this voltage, it is like in the opposite polarity with this Vin. Like if you apply the KVL here, you will get minus Vn. Okay, and here what is the voltage? Plus Vm. So if you see, these two are in opposite, like that is a let's take this is A and B. So if you see this one, EM minus Vn, so these two are in opposite polarity. Okay, so that's why we are calling it effect opposes the cause. Now I'm not denoting any dot or dot convention here. At the final we'll see where dot had to put and where the where current how current is going. Okay, now see here, so I made the winding, so there is two possibilities. Let's discuss. Suppose this is positive and this is negative. Okay, let's take this is positive and this is negative. This positive means current is flowing in this direction. Okay, again for the same transformer, primary I'm not changing, I'm changing the secondary, I'm changing the polarity, same winding also. See, this is in the below the limb and this is also below the limb, so I'm changing the polarity. This is minus and this is plus. Okay, as the plus is here, minus here, current flow like this. Okay, if the current is flowing in the load in this direction, that means this is plus, this is minus. Again see here, plus is here and minus is here, that means current flow like this. Suppose take a resistance, take a resistance, the current flow like this, that means we are taking here plus and here minus, likewise here also. Okay, so if it is plus, see here, if it is a plus and this is also plus, and if it is a minus and this is also a minus, here also this is plus and this is minus, and here current is flowing in this direction, and in this current is flowing in this direction like this, again like this current will flow. Here also see, current is flowing like this in this direction. Now apply the right hand thumb rule for finding the flux direction, and here also apply the right hand thumb rule for finding the flux direction. If you see, current is flowing like this, okay, so suppose this is my limb. I will give you the example, so I am using the some instrument to show you. Suppose see, this is my limb, okay, so suppose this is my limb, okay, my convention is, see, current is flowing and I made the winding on the top of the limb. That means, so this is my right hand, okay, so this is on the, this is my winding on the top of the limb, okay. If my if my four fingers represents the current, then my thumb represents the flux, so like this, okay. So if the current is flowing in this direction, flux will flow in like upwards. So here also see, current is flowing in this direction, that means flux will flow in the upward direction. So here, what is the flux direction you got? Like this. So flux will flow like this. That is the, can represent as a primary flux. Similarly, here also see, this is my limb, okay. So if the current is flowing in this direction, let's see for this first. If the current is flowing in this direction, then what is the flux direction? Here also flux direction is same. Why? Because winding are same. It's a primary. Okay, so again take the limb. So this is my limb. Now this is my winding, okay, right hand. Like I made the winding like this, like this, below the limb. So if the current is flowing in this direction, okay, so my four fingers represents the current direction, then so this is my flux direction, okay. So in this diagram, same, current is flowing in this direction, then the flux direction is the upwards, so like this. So this is my secondary flux. So if you observe, primary flux and secondary flux are in opposite direction. That means it's, okay, it obeys the Lenz law. Okay, so this is possible. Okay, so this is possible. But coming to here, it's like winding is same, but the current is reversed. Okay, here current is going inside the winding, which, but current is going outside the winding. Okay, so that means the flux direction will changes. So initially flux is in the upward direction, now flux is in the downward direction, secondary flux, just opposite to that one. This is why, yes. Now see, flux is flowing, like primary flux is flowing in this direction, secondary flux is flowing in the same direction. So this is opposing the Lenz's law. So that's why this configuration is not possible. Okay. Again, let's take one more configuration. And from that, we will draw some results. Finally, we will conclude this one. Now see, I made one more connection. So like this. So I haven't made the connection diagram here. So now we will make the connection diagram. Second, primary I am not changing here. So I am only making the secondary winding. So I am making the winding connection on the top of the limb like this. Okay, here, so here I am connecting the load. In this also I am making the same winding like this. Here I am making the connection like this. Okay, so secondary flux must opposes the primary flux, then only that is a transformer action, then only it's satisfying the Lenz's law. Otherwise there is no transformer action. Why? That's why, like, if the primary flux is this and secondary flux is in the opposite direction, okay, suppose if I increases the current, secondary current, okay, this is my transformer, there is a winding here, okay, if I increases the secondary current, what happens? The secondary flux get increases, okay. So this secondary flux increases, so and this current is increased, as this current is increases, this current is also increases. How much increment in this current? So that will reflect in the primary also. So here also current will increases. Now as the current increases, primary flux is also increases, and here as the current here increases, secondary flux is also increases. So these two fluxes are opposite direction. That means what is the increment in the secondary, okay, so that will reflect in the secondary flux. Similarly, what is the increment in the primary, that will reflect in the primary flux. So these fluxes get subtracting, so that's why you are getting the constant flux, that is the flux is equal to constant. That's why we are calling transformer as a constant flux device, okay. That's it. Suppose I am taking secondary and this is primary initial not. So if some current, there is an increment in the flux, that is a phi. And here also there is an increment in the current, like because of secondary, primary current get increases, and because of this current, this flux is also get increases. So that is also same phi. If I subtract these two, that means phi p naught plus phi minus phi s naught minus phi. So these two again cancel, again I will get phi p naught minus phi s naught. So this is always constant. Okay, that's why you are calling transformer as a constant flux device. Now coming to here, again takes the two polarities, positive negative and negative positive. Okay, positive means current is going inside the load like this, and here positive, here negative means current is flowing in like this. Okay, now see, so if the current, if this is a positive and this is also positive and this is negative, okay, now primary flux is flowing like this. This is a primary flux, and here also primary flux is flowing like this. Now what about the secondary flux? Like if you observe carefully, what is the secondary flux? So for this winding, okay, I made the winding on top of the limb, and here also top of the limb, but I changing the current direction. Here current is flowing like this, okay, like this, and here also current is flowing like this. Yes, so okay, now again take the, so this is my limb I'm making on the limb, so this is my limb, okay, so this is my winding thumb, this is my current direction. So see here, if my forefinger represents the current direction, then my thumb represents the flux direction. This is on the limb, so flux will go up. If the current is in this direction, flux will go down. So current is in this direction in which configuration? First or second? Second. In second, if you see, current is going in this direction, then flux is in downward direction like this, okay. So this is my secondary flux, and here opposite, so I'm changing the, as the current is changing, so the flux will also get changes. So this is my secondary flux, okay. Now here these two are in opposite direction, so this configuration is possible, and here these two are in same direction, so this configuration is not possible. Now see, what are the two possible configurations? So in the previous, so this is a possible configuration, and this, now this is a possible configuration. In these two configurations, okay, observe carefully. Suppose this is my primary, okay, current is flowing like this. If I am applying at any instant, the supply voltage is like this, positive and negative, okay, at the same instant, okay, the load voltage is positive, negative here, okay. So if I take positive instantaneous voltage as dot. Okay, then see, I'm taking this positive instantaneous voltage as a dot here, and here also I'm taking the dot, and see this here also, this is my positive and negative, this is dot, and positive is here, so this is dot. Okay, now see here, primary current is entering the dot, and here secondary current is leaving the dot. That means from the dot current is going outside, but here current is entering into the dot. So here current enters the dot. Okay, here current leaves the dot. Okay, so whatever configurations you'll see, and we'll draw the conclusion from that one. Now here also see, positive is here also, current entering the dot, and here current is leaving the dot, then only configuration like transformer action is possible. So in both the cases, like whether winding is like this or like this, but what is the conclusion? If the current enters in the primary, it must leave in the secondary. And here also, if the current enters in the primary dot, it must leave the dot. That's it. So in general what happens is, we don't know whether the winding is done on the limb or below the limb. So that's why in general we are writing like this. This is a transformer. Okay, this is the equivalent of to the transformer for a ideal transformer. Now suppose this is my dot here. Okay, and this is my dot here. Let us take, I'm taking dot as a positive, I already discussed. So this is my positive E1 and this is my positive E2. So obviously this is negative. So now discuss on polarity, like current direction. Suppose if the current enters like this in the secondary I2, the current entering the dot, that means it must leave the dot. That means current will go like this in the primary. This is I1. So current will go like this. Okay, there is no significant, like this positive and negative for dot convention only, but like by considering any one of the direction of current, we can conclude what is the current direction of in the secondary. Now see, here current is flowing in this direction. Okay, and here also current is flowing in this direction. That means it is entering the dot and it is leaving the dot. Okay, so we can write like this also. Usually we follow this second convention in many of the problems. This one. Now see, here let me take like this. I'm taking dots here. Okay, so that means this is positive E1 and this is positive E2. Generally we consider like this only. Okay, and this is my supply. Supply is giving the current, that is I1 current. Now see, current is going in this direction. Current is entering the dot. That means it must leave the dot in the secondary. So this is the secondary, it must leave the dot. This is the dot, current is leaving the dot. Okay, that means here current is in downward and current is in upward. Like everywhere it's not like that. It's based on the dot convention. Whether is dot here, and suppose if dot is on opposite sides like this, then currents are in same like this. Okay, don't remember, just remember one thing. If current in one winding enters the dot, so it must leave the dot in other winding. That's it. Okay, so that's all about this video. In the next video, we'll discuss some problems on winding connections. So based on these polarities, okay, so there are a few good problems on these polarities, okay, so we'll discuss on that problems in the next video. Thanks for watching this video, and please like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.